Hello again. Today we are continuing my tutorial series. So now that you have made both your music and your title screen, you now need to apply both. This is a very important process before you can post it. So I typically am going to go and I'm going to select the two things I want, which is they're on my desktop, so I need to find desktop. I need to get out of there, so I need to go find the desktop. Wait a second, how is this file this hierarchy set up? This is absolutely users. The fish. Then you're going to go and you're going to look for desktop. This is the one you want. This is where I put all my stuff. Everything is here. Pirated games, all the covers you can see. All of the things I've rendered. All of my sound effects. And we go through here and we find the two we want. This one. We drag and drop it into here. And then we have the title screen. Of course, the next part is getting. Where is my new song? I must have titled it. Oh, yes. Hello. That's what it translates into. It's German for hello. I don't even know how I know that much. We go to 2,200. Get it as close as you can. Because you don't want those extra frames. Those are not important. That is exactly there. I did not expect that. So now you have your title screen and your music. You may be asking, what do I do now? Well, the answer is, you render, and with a bit of research, I figured out how to do this exactly to get it to be what I wanted it to be, which is an MP4. Well, I got it close enough. It's still postable. It's just not an MP4. So now we have this. I've opened up that. You need to set this to the exact number that the length of your music and this is. Well, only your music. Doesn't matter about this thing, because this is just one image. And then you're going to set your output to your desired location. In my case, I'm going to select the desktop. And accept. Don't forget to click that, otherwise you're going to have to do it over again. We don't want it to be a PNG. We want it to be this one. FFmpeg video. Why do I want it that? Well, that is, and these are two different options also, if you didn't know. But why I want this like this is because it means that my video is going to be something that's a video, not just an image. So next you can choose grayscale or red, green, blue. Do you want it to be black and white or colorful like this one right here? In this case, we'll leave it this one. It's the default one, hopefully, for you. If not, you can change it. And then next, I choose MPEG4. This is MP4, I think. I do believe. It doesn't matter. It just works anyway. Then MP3. And then you are going to now be ready to render. Without this, they won't play anything. So next we go to render. And then you choose render animation. And then this is opened. This is going to render. This will take a bit. Unfortunately, we don't have a bit, so in the meantime, we're just going to go and I'll probably use Blender on this too. But the program I used for this is Blender, if you didn't know. I forgot to mention that. So as you can see, this is going to make a very long time. So in that time, let's just stroll around our files. Let's look at all the cover options we had. There's this one. It's a video. Yep, that's pretty cool. No, that one was used for the fish. I typically don't name these until after they have the title screen, and then I throw it together. I don't know if that's a good idea. It's up to you. Whatever works for you. So as you can see, I have all of the videos. I have them saved because I cannot put them on MP3 player and play those. Oh my gosh, only 12 seconds in. Well, in the meantime, let's just talk a bit about. Well, actually, it doesn't really matter anyway. So you're gonna wait till this is finished. When this is finished, then it's ready to be published. You're gonna wanna find a title. Of course, in this case, once it finishes, it's just going to my desktop. If you do not select desktop, or if you forgot to, don't worry. You go to somewhere in here. I have. You go down into here, and then you go to Windows 86, and or no, not Windows 86. Just go to Windows, and you look for. It's TMP, temporary, or something like that. It's your default location where it's going to be made. Or, if you really wanted to know where it was, then it should say TMP here. And that means temporary. I do believe that is what it means. But typically, you don't want it going there, so you're going to want to send it to your desktop. Also, if you forgot to render it as a video, then that's a problem for you. That's one of the things you don't want to forget. If you rendered it as grayscale, you can do this for any video, really. Grayscale or red, blue, green. If it's like a highlights video for like something like sports or something like that, you can do grayscale. So let's say you were gonna do that. You use grayscale, then it's pretty much all the same, the whole process. Don't forget your audio codec. This is very important. I don't believe I actually might have mentioned this earlier, but this is very important. So I chose MP3, and then this one, MPEG4. I think that stands for, or the shortened version is MP4, but I always get the output as HKX or something like that, or something similar. But if you did it all the same way I did it, you should still be able to post it. And it will also have the audio. So what these do, this is your start frame, so this would show how much of this or where you're starting at. So if you wanted to, you could set it to negative 10, negative 20, but I don't see why you would do that. Just leave it at default 1. And then this one should be the length of this. If it is not the length of that, it's going to cut off bits of it, and it's going to be shorter. Of course, it wouldn't have taken this long. So in total, this song has turned out to be 1 minute 30 seconds long. And in our rendering screen, as you can see here, I think you should be able to see it. It takes about 1 minute. He keeps estimating that I have like 0.1 second or so left. It takes a very long time. Then once this is done, you're going to find that it is in the destination, and then it's ready to post. That's about it. Of course, if you're doing a longer video, it's going to take a very long time to render. So, some of my earlier tutorials, which I'm going to be rendering soon, and then posting, I always render it. I recommend rendering it. I mean, if you don't, then it's just gonna ruin it. But yeah, I'm gonna have to render some of those earlier. Probably the 12-minute ones are gonna be the first ones, because they're the shortest. Of course, there's many ways you can do it. guess it's gonna be it for now.